We're here today with Jim Cowper, who is running for Sylvan Lake City Council. How are you today?
I'm wonderful.
Well, thank you for doing this. Can you tell us why you've decided to run for City Council?
So first of all, I'd like to thank Oakland County Times and you, Crystal, for all you do for all of Oakland County. This is a great public service. I've made a bunch of notes here, so you'll see me glance down because there's a lot of things to cover. So my desire to run for City Council is really to represent the residents of the city and the city's future. I'm running for City Council because I think we need a leadership change. As a 34-year resident, I've been asked to run for City Council by several past City Council members, Stuart Bandoline, Pete Peters, Rick Erickson, Sharon Marina, and numerous residents. And the SPAR leadership group has asked me to consider being a candidate. So after careful discussions with my wife and all of these great supporters, I decided that I think now is the time for me to become a City Council member. The message is really clear. I want to be an active listener and a voice for the residents of the city of Sylvan Lake.
So are there any specific issues that you want to work on if you're elected?
There's quite a few, and I'm going to try and just keep it to four. So the first one is our master plan in our zoning. It's been almost 10 years since the master plan's been looked at, and that's a bit too long. However, it's an opportunity now for us to look at it. Sylvan Lake is so unique that we have to be really careful with the master plan that we design and make sure that it fits our needs. Oftentimes the master planning companies have a tendency to use a little bit of a cookie cutter approach. And we got to make sure that because we're so small and we have high density and we have the lake and we have an Orchard Lake corridor, that we have to make sure that the city plan we develop really, really fits the needs of our city and our residents. So that's the first one. The vacant property on Orchard Lake Road and the Whitfield School property. And we have a very unique farm-to-table restaurant that's being built at the moment. These are really wonderful opportunities for the city to maybe have some game-changing outcomes. However, we, again, need to be very careful because we're so small that we take these approaches that are best suited to the residents of the city and to our neighboring cities. You know, Keego Harbor and Orchard Lake are also our very important neighbors. The next one I want to talk about is our millage. We have a millage on the November ballot, and it's a critical millage in that we're combining some old millages into one general millage. In theory, that could be very good for our city and give the city some flexibility in operating. I spent time with John, our city manager, and we talked about the millage, and we kind of have, you know, two real big things going on is our roads are in terrible decline and we need to rebuild the roads. And then we have water and sewer challenges in the city. And so a lot of this millage funding will go toward those things. And roads are time consuming. They're expensive. We want them to be built right and last. And the same with our sewer systems and our water. Very critical to our city, but they're old. And so the millage is really important, but it's going to be really important to have great fiscal management of those things when we look to rebuild them. The next one is public safety. I spent time with our new chief, Bassett. He seems to be a great guy. He probably is going to be a wonderful asset to our city. We needed a full-time chief. I like his energy. I like his experience at coming from Southfield, a very large police department, to coming to something so small like Sylvan. Now, the police department is 50% of our budget, so it's a large, large part of what goes on in our city. Obviously, it's critical to the safety of our residents. It's critical to our senior residents. It's critical to our property values. So I really look forward to the chief bringing new, great ideas and thoughts into our unique city. The last one is a little bit longer plan. In my discussions with John Martin, our city manager, we talked about someday in the near future, not tomorrow, but someday John will likely seek to retire. And he's been a great, great ambassador and public servant to the city of Sylvan Lake for decades. And it's going to be critical to have people on city council that have experience and wherewithal to look for and seek and vet and potentially replace John sometime in the future. So those are kind of the four main ones. And it's a really critical time in the city of Sylvan Lake that we're going through, you know, the budget, millage, roads, sewers, a new police chief at some time, not today, but sometime in the future, possibly replacing our city manager. The Whitfield property and what's going on there. There's a lot going on in the city. So I think it's very critical as to who we have on city council.
Can you tell us some of the professional experience and skills you bring to the table?
Sure. Thank you for asking. So I'm 35 years plus of running private business. As the president of Contract Professionals, you know, we lead teams of hundreds of employees, and our budgets are in tens of millions of dollars. My background has been very broad, working in private business. I've worked across the entire United States, had managed business in Great Britain, and I've managed business in India. So I bring a broad business background. The city of Sylvan Lake's annual budget is about $2 million. So although it's not a large budget, it has to be really, really fiscally managed tightly. And in my business background lends to a lot of very tight fiscal budgetary skills. I'm the chairman of the board of DFCU Financial. That's a $6 billion Michigan-based credit union. So I have a lot of banking and budget fiscal experience. I'm a board member at University of Detroit High School, 144-year private enterprise that is public or privately funded. So again, budgets are very, very important in how the school is run. And lastly, I'm a board member at the National Veterans Business Development Council. It's a not-for-profit entity that supports veteran businesses and veterans across the United States. So having experience with these boards and my business experience, I understand how to work as a team. I understand how to work with boards and board members. And many of those skills will apply to how the city of Sylvan Lake government works. You know, team building and effective communication is really, really important. So those are the skills I bring on that end.
Now, what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the Sylvan Lake community?
As a 34-year-old resident of the city, and my family history goes back 70 years, we've had someone continuously living in the city since 1950. And my daughter Danielle just bought a house in the city, so she'll be the fifth generation of people from our family. So we're very committed to the city. My wife Elizabeth and I are avid walkers, so we use the lakes and the parks and in the community grounds quite a bit. So the beaches and parks are important. They need constant maintenance, you know, geese management for public health is a concern. So way back, I was very active in the Rails to Trails project. I was a big advocate of the trail. I was always concerned about the cost and how it fits into the city budget. And the Rails to Trails program, the maintenance for our city is about $10,000 a year. Now, again, when you look at a budget of $2 million, you know, $10,000 is a number that is reasonably significant. Again, supportive of the trail, but we always want to manage the cost. I was very active in the beginning of the building of the new community center. I was an advocate for making the building bigger so that it could be open every day and residents could use the community center. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. This community center costs the city about $40,000 a year. So how much it costs to maintain the building versus what we get in rental revenues back from the community center. So it's about a $40,000 delta. So I would like to see some ways going forward how we could be more creative in the use of the building and maybe eliminate some of those expenses. I was an active member of SPAR, our recent community outreach program, and it was very exciting to see the city unite over a common topic. We had numerous people in the city that have known each other for years and years and years, but never really worked toward a common goal. the energy was very infectious. And I think that is a huge, huge plus for the city going forward, that we can use that energy and how the residents united to move and improve other things in the city and be an asset to city government and the city council. So I think those things are important. Lastly, I'm a lifetime member of the Oakland County Boat Club. And I've always felt it was really important how the boat club and the city work together and that they're complementary to one another. So that's always been a goal for me, to make sure that those two things work well.
Well, in this race, there is some competition for this position. Why should the voters pick you?
Thank you to everyone who's thrown their hat in the ring to run for city council. It's a voluntary position, and we need people to volunteer. So I'm glad that there's several of us in the race. Our city's facing some pretty large challenges. You know, we talked about the millage and the roads and the sewers. We have a new chief of police, which is exciting. And our city manager's done a tremendous job over all these years. But these are things that are going to be lengthy. They're going to be time consuming. They're going to be expensive. We talked about the chief of police as 50% of our budget, not the chief of police, the department. And that's important to manage that. The Orchard Lake corridor, we have some vacant businesses, the Whitfield School property. We talked about the new farm to table restaurant. Those are all things that will be challenges going forward. I feel my business experience, my active participation on boards, my 34 years of living in the city, all make me a very viable candidate to help manage these projects and these programs going forward. I know a vote for James Cowper is a vote for all city residents. That's my goal. Thank you.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
I have a website, jamescowper.com, and the website is interactive. They can send notes. They can ask for comments. I'm pretty active in posting on Facebook, which is tied to jamescowper.com, and also on the About Sylvan Lake. So I'm very open. My cell phone number is public. It's 248-762-1822. Please call me or text me at any time.
Thank you so much for doing the interview with us today.
Thank you very much.